The pregame festivities are over, and we're just about set to get this game underway. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. Throws left, picked off.
Really nice cover skills shown here this time. That's exactly what you want to see from your young corner.
From the 24-yard line, it's first down. And he's taken down around the 25-yard line.
These guys, especially in the secondary, really get after it and can make life hard for the play callers on the other side of the ball.
The shotgun and five wideouts. Quick throw, incomplete, wanted his receiver.
That's a miscommunication between a quarterback and a wide receiver right there. They need to get their signals straight.
From the 25-yard line, it's third down, five wide. Under pressure. Zips it to his receiver. Touchdown. And he adds the extra point. So a short three-play, 24-yard drive, and they get it in for seven. The score now, 7-0. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He sends this one deep. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Cougars are right where they want to be early in this one, Parker.
Well, this is what their coach talked about, getting off to a great start. The defense did their job, and it's nice to see the offense move the ball down the field and also get some points on the board.
Now, here comes the offense, and you've got to wonder if that last interception's weighing on the quarterback's mind at all.
It may be early, but don't think the coaches haven't spent a lot of time reminding these guys how important it is to take care of the football.
He gets out to about the 35-yard line. So they pick up three on the option keeper. And they push him out at the 32. And he breaks one on third down.
Good call. Great execution. And again, we've seen this before, and the result is a big third down run.
And they make the stop around the 32-yard line. Look to convert here on another third down. And he might want it all here and does. Can't connect.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
It's up. Got it.
Yeah, he got some good leg behind it, and he kicked an accurate ball right between the goalposts.
7-3, BYU. Oregon ready to kick this one off. Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The Cougars offense, I thought, answered the doubters big time with an impressive opening drive, and they got on the board first.
Yeah, when you're in a hostile environment, you want to play with a little bit of a chip on your shoulder and just show people that you're not intimidated by the environment. They sure did that first time out.
Brigham Young holds a four-point lead. Scrambling around. They'll bring him down at the 36. And that was a nice pickup by the quarterback.
Brent, I think this guy's amazing. He has an uncanny ability to scramble, and it showed right there on that play.
From their own 36-yard line, first down. They come out on an empty backfield. Tackle made around the 50-yard line.
He really showed some good speed there.
I'll tell you, no question. When you talk about being able to turn on the jets and leave everybody in the dust, you have to mention this young man. He's got skills, but his speed is what the pro scouts are drooling about.
Caught out in the open. That's a great tackle at the 36-yard line.
Number 12 brings him down at the 36-yard line.
From the 36-yard line, first down. There are five wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. He's going to try and scramble. He's at the 20. He's tackled at about the 17-yard line.
Hey, sometimes the defense does everything right, and they still lose. That time they had tight coverage, which left no options other than for the quarterback to take off.
Gets out to about the 15-yard line. From the 15-yard line, second down. They come out in a five-wide set. Tackled after a decent pickup.
Call it a gain of 4 yards. That'll bring up third and four.
Got an opening. Nice move, and he scores. And that's as pretty an option play as you'll ever see.
It took all fall practice for the quarterback and the halfback to get their timing down. Man, do they look good now.
And he hits the PAT. A seven-play, 75-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
And, Brad, right now the offensive line just winning the battle in the trenches, opening up some big running room.
So our score, 14-3. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Cougars really came prepared to play defense today, and the plan is working.
Well, so far in this game, you've got to tip your cap to the defensive coordinator. He has clearly done a very good job of getting his team ready to play, and they have done a nice job of slowing down this very explosive offense.
They need to show a little giddy up now, because if they don't start eating into this deficit, they could easily fall out of the game. And a quick throw. Knocked out of bounds at the 45-yard line.
I'll tell you what, this defensive coordinator is not afraid to send the house. He brought every linebacker, and the quarterback was still able to convert the first down. Seeing the whole field and finding the guy who had the best chance of making a catch.
He's into the open field. And he's tackled at the 21. Down at the 20-yard line.
Call it a gain of 1 yard. That makes it second and eight.
He's
taken down at the 19. And he gets a yard on the run. From the 19-yard line, third down. Quick pass going back to his running back. And they'll get him in the backfield. That's a loss of about three.
Pretty good stand there. They weren't fooled at all by the offensive play call.
So at the end of one quarter, BYU in front, 14-3. And we're back for more action here in quarter number two. And they can make this a one-possession game with this kick right here. The kick is up, and it's through the uprights. Oregon lines up for the kickoff. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Brigham Young holds an 8-point advantage. Now he's scrambling. And down he goes at the 33-yard line. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Quick out to his receiver. Tackle at about the 35.
That's a gain of two on the play. First down.
And he's immediately tackled. A little toss across the middle.
Nothing flashy at all. But now, that first down marker is a lot closer.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. It's caught. First down, and he's out of bounds.
This passing game can be very effective if you don't get enough pressure on the quarterback. They use their personnel well and can be very tough to defend.
He gets to about the 27-yard line. From the 27-yard line, it's first down.
Hey, alert 48. Alert. Hey, we're going to mic the 48 right now.
Ready. Just throws this one away.
Get up.
Larry. Brigham Young is up by 8.
Ready. 59 Philly.
A gain of about 4 yards on the draw. And this play is number 8 on the drive. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with 5 wideouts. And he's taken down at about the 11. From the 11-yard line, first down. Fires quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab. This is the 10th play of this drive. Caught with room to work, and they make the stop right around the 6-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards.
They'll line it up again on third down.
Let's go.
Defensive coordinator anticipating this five-wide set. He comes in with his dime package. He scrambles, runs with it, and he's got room. Touchdown, Cougars.
Oh, that's a great job and some tough running right there. When you get close to the end zone, things get very tight. It's tough to maneuver.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. So an 11-play, 75-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result. So the score now, 21-6. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Makes it out to maybe the 19-yard line.
You know, this offense is doing a pretty good job moving the football. The problem is they're not coming up with touchdowns. The offensive coordinator who's been up here next to us, Brad, the booth next to us, he's actually just taken off his headsets, and I think he's going down to the field to be next to the quarterback and the rest of this offense to try to engage with them to realize how important it is to finish these drives.
Makes it to the 27. Makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line. Nice run up the middle. Oregon's going to take their first time out of the half. And there's 2 minutes remaining in the half. 6 yards there on the counter. He's at midfield. He's pushed out of bounds around the 39-yard line. First down. From the 39-yard line, first down. Hit out of bounds, right around the 30.
That brings in second and
22, by 22.
And he hits him hard at the 19-yard line. Oregon's going to have to use their second time out of the half. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 19-yard line. A total of 100 yards on his carry so far.
Sooner or later, they're going to have to start keying in on the run. And when that happens, I'd look for him to start to try to do some more with the passing game.
And he converts the extra point. It looks like they're ready for the kick. He sends this one deep. He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 22-yard line.
Brad, let's see if this offense can maintain the rhythm that they established on that last drive. Not just putting points on the board, but driving the length of the field to be able to eventually put points up. I think that's going to be important for them to try to keep that confidence going here on this drive.
They just took what the defense gave them on that play.
Yeah, you're right. That was a good job of getting that pass completed for positive yardage.
Brigham Young up by 8. Fires out to his receiver. That one goes for good yardage and a first down.
Yeah, that's just a nice gain on second down.
First down.
From their own 35-yard line, it's first down.
Hey, alert 48. Let's go! Hey,
now he tries to buy some time. They'll get the first down.
He made the correct decision to tuck it and go.
Hey, alert 48. Hey, come on, Mike, the 48.
Got hit and still completed it. He's on the run. Quarterback's going to run it, and he's got room to work. So the quarterback scrambles for about 8 yards. Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 41. The Cougars call a timeout. That's their second of the half. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry, and he tackles him hard at the 32-yard line.
98 Weasel! 98 Weasel!
Makes it first and 10.
Ready! Blue 88! Easy, easy, easy! Lucky 95!
Pass is tipped away.
Brad, I think the quarterback here really forced the issue. I think he tried to squeeze that football into a really tight window, and he's very fortunate the safety didn't step in front of it and intercept that football.
A quarterback in the gun with five receivers. Tries to scramble, but he's sacked. Brigham Young holds an 8-point advantage. He's scrambling. Tackle made at the 32. The quarterback scramble gains 3 yards. It's fourth down. They'll call on the field goal unit here for this long field goal attempt. Brigham Young is hoping to make this a two-score game. The kick is away. It's long enough, and he splits the uprights. So at the end of the half, the Cougars in front, 24-13.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Davis, David Pollack here in the studio, as always, to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. David, when we've talked to offensive coordinators everywhere, one of their key phrases, chunk plays or explosive plays, whatever the vernacular is, they want big chunks of yardage in the passing game. Well, so far, these two teams are completing passes, but they're not getting chunks of yardage.
Yeah, and unless you make a defense honor the deeper passes, if you just keep throwing screens real quick on the outside and they keep tackling you and wrapping you up, and you're not getting that yards after the catch, then I don't have to back up. I don't have to honor that deep ball. It makes it a lot easier to defend. So they got to find more creative ways to push the ball down the field a little bit, get bigger plays, because it's hard to sustain drives all the way down the field. You got to have those big plays to make it a little bit easier on an offense and get them in scoring position sometimes, or sometimes just score outright from the 50-yard line.
David and I will stay locked in on everything going on in college football. We're going to wrap it up here in the studio. Just about time to get you out to your second half. Brad and Kirk, ready with a call.
All right, Reese, David, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback. So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field.
Watch the run, watch the run, watch the run.
Hey, alert 48. Hey, down. Blue 80.
He's tackled at the 35.
That's good for a gain of 10 yards.
So it's second down, and they're only about a foot away from picking up the first down.
Hey, alert 48. Hey, we're going to Mike the 48 right now. Let's go.
Here we go.
He's on the run. They'll bring him down at the 45. And he has a huge run.
I'll tell you right now, this guy is arguably one of the fastest players in college football today. There you see him turn it upfield with such fluidity and quickness.
Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. Looks quick to his tight end, and he can't hang on.
Number 82, the intended receiver on the play.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 45-yard line. Makes the catch, and look out.
He made a good read here to find his teammate. That's sound decision-making.
That'll make it 35.
They'll line up with five wide receivers.
Hey, alert 48.
Throws it. Big catch there as they knock him out of bounds.
It's good for a gain of 31 yards. First down.
So let's see how the defense responds now. It's first down and 10.
Yeah. You don't want none. Hey, alert 48. Hey, we're going to mic the 48 right now.
Let's go.
Inside the 10. Makes it out to about the 7.
That makes it first and goal.
Boy, was he drilled as he let go of that football.
Yeah, he's going to feel that one tomorrow.
From the 7-yard line, it's second down. 5 wide. He's going to try and scramble. Decides to tuck it in, and he's got space.
Touchdown, BYU!
He makes the PAT. They line up to kick this one away. He just drills this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
The Cougars coaching staff's got to be elated over on the sideline about what they plan to do with this wide receiver and the plans coming to fruition.
Absolutely, and they continue to be able to find ways to give him the football. That's the thing that's been probably most impressive, not just his ability, but how they've moved him around and gotten the football to him in different ways. It makes it very tough on the defense.
But the defense is fired up, responding and reacting to that sack. Not only do they get the quarterback, but they hit him and hit him hard. I think that can really create some confidence for this defense. The next time this quarterback drops back to throw, you got to be thinking he's going to be a little bit gun-shy and concerned about the pressure that this defense is putting on.
Sheds that one. Makes it out to about the 39. Scrambling around, and he's tackled at the 39. Nowhere to go on the quarterback scramble.
Boy, the senior linebacker's experience really showed on that run. He sniffed it out perfectly and made the tackle.
Now he's scrambling. And he's going to be sacked.
The protection broke down. The defense was in the backfield in a hurry, and they brought the quarterback down. Nice play.
That brings up third and 12.
From their own 37-yard line, it's third down.
Mike 41, Mike 41. I don't even know why this team screwed up.
And a quick throw. That's a great tackle. The 39-yard line. A couple of yards that time on the screen.
Fourth down.
Oh, excellent punt. Brought down at the 24. The Ducks have simply rocked the college football world with an astounding effort in this one.
This is one of the biggest upsets I think we've seen all year. You know what's great? They didn't worry about any of the outside distractions. They just kind of locked in to themselves and their coaches, getting ready for this football game, and it's really paid off for them.
The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, 5 wide receivers in the formation.
That makes it second and 8.
Second down, 8 yards to go. Ball on the 26.
Hey, alert 48. Hey, we're going to mic the 48.
Set. Blue 88.
Motion.
And he is drilled at the 19.
Loss of 7. That makes it 3rd and 15.
Red 85!
fires it out. And this one's going to get intercepted.
Hey, this could potentially turn this football game around. They're down by a couple scores, but if you're the offense and you're on the sideline and you're not feeling good about yourself and your defense comes up with an interception like that, boy, oh boy, you're grabbing your helmet, sprinting on that field, and you're ready to go.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 48. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. Brought down around the 47-yard line. He scrambled and he sacked.
Well, we talked all week with these coaches, and even when we met with them yesterday out at practice, they told us there were some big concerns about facing these defensive ends. They thought that they might be able to hold up against him, maybe get the ball out of the pocket a little bit quicker, maybe use running backs and tight ends to help with double teams on the outside. But right now, whatever they thought they might be able to do, they better get back to that drawing board because these defensive ends are just too quick.
Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 42. Catches it and hit immediately for a loss.
That is a loss of five. That makes it fourth and 12.
The defense has everybody on the line. I think they're going to come after this one. He really got a hold of that one. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. The offense will take the field, hoping for a better result than their last drive.
I look for the offense to come out with the same game plan as before. You don't make changes after one play.
He's taken down around the 30-yard line. From their own 30-yard line, first down. Throw out to the receiver, incomplete. And they push him out at the 47-yard line. So at the end of three, the Cougars in front, 31-13. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. And they get him in the backfield for a loss. So it's second and 13. Ball on their own 45.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
They'll spread the field with five wide. Tackle right around the 44-yard line.
He was able to deaden that kick perfectly, and he gives them a long field to work with.
So they're just about set to get the game going again. He's to the 20, makes it to the 24.
Back.
nice game. And they may need to hurry here.
Well, you'd think so, but there doesn't seem to be much urgency on the field right now.
Throws it out and off. He's hit hard for a loss. 3-yard loss there.
Pretty good stand there. They weren't fooled at all by the offensive play call.
That'll make it 39.
Third and nine. Ball on the 25.
Ready!
Out of bounds, right around the 28-yard line. Fires out to his wide out.
That's a 14 yards of play. That makes it first and 10.
3-19!
Now he tries to buy some time. And he's taken down around the 45-yard line.
That's a gain of 3 on the play. That'll make it 77.
Just under 3 to go in regulation. Third down, and they need to get it inside the 48.
41's coming. 41's a mic.
Watch the run. Watch the run.
Ready.
Gets it out. He's met immediately. They're stopped for a 5-yard loss.
That play was sort of out of sync from the start, but you have to also recognize that the defense made a great play. They read it from the get-go.
He puts it away, and it's a great kick. Oh, man, he took him down hard. The Cougars came out. Man, they were on a mission, it seemed like, from the opening kickoff. They didn't let up.
Yeah, I think somebody forgot to tell them that they're supposed to be heavy underdogs in this game. But they have really shown everybody, you and I and everybody watching this game, they are a team to be taken seriously.
Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Maybe a yard on the run by the tailback.
One thing about this linebacker over the years that separates him from the rest are his instincts and ability to make the play. That's a nice tackle by the senior.
From their own 24-yard line.
Here we go.
Second down. And he's level at the 26-yard line.
Defense. That was picture perfect, three and out. Good series for these guys.
That makes it fourth and eight.
Under a minute left. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. He wasn't breaking that tackle. What a hit. I'm sure there are a lot of fans out there hoping for a miracle, but I seriously doubt we're going to see one today. Makes the catch, and he's got nowhere to go. Oregon's going to take their first time out of the half. Second and 7. Ball on the 38-yard line. Slings it. Intercepted, and I think I can hear the fat lady singing.
I
just don't think he saw the defender, and he threw the ball right at him. That's what happens when you focus on one guy. You get tunnel vision.
And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. Favorite play in football if you're a quarterback. Take a knee. The Cougars know that they have to enjoy this guy while they've got him, because somewhere down the line he's going to be at the next level.
Well, that'll definitely be in his future, but for now he needs to sit back and just enjoy this performance. And really, the play caller, the quarterback, the offensive line, the receivers, the entire group as just a whole should feel good about their performance.
That's it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you soon.